Greetings, New Zealand naturopath Eric Bakker. I'm the author of Candida Crusher, and I'm also the formulator of a range of products called Canxida with an X. Thanks for checking out my video. Question here from a person called Tetrid Monafa in Kenya. I'm not sure if Tetrid's male or female, so but I'll just use the word Tetrid. Tetrid's asking me if fecal transplants can cause chronic candida. So that's a question. Can fecal transplant cause chronic candida? I'll tell you a bit about fecal transplants. I had the good fortune a few years ago to be in Sydney at a function, and I had dinner with Dr. Tom Borody, and in fact a few doctors that were there. And I remember speaking about fecal transplants, and Tom's clinic was the one, in fact, that pioneered fecal transplants. Back in the mid-1980s, Tom worked with patients. I think it might have been with clostridium difficile with a particular infection. And you know, trial this method, which has become highly successful. So the Center for Digestive Diseases is a world famous clinic now that's helped people from all around the world with many chronic digestive problems. They've got some incredibly passionate and talented doctors that work in this clinic. One of the doctors I spoke with said to me that when they first did the fecal transplants, they put a lot of people through the program, and they had a pilot project, I think of about 10 or 15 patients, and the procedure worked very, very well. But the doctor said in nearly all cases, the patients would come back within 8 to 12 months with the same problem. So, you know, the treatment was a success, but the long-term outcome failed because the patient didn't stay with the right kind of protocol and lifestyle and diet, you know, to maintain digestive wellness. So, but that's not what the video is about. The video is, can fecal transplants cause chronic candida? It can't really cause chronic candida. What it can do, though, is change the gut microbiota environment significantly. It can make you feel pretty darn good. And if you keep working on that wellness, you can really improve your health to a very high level. The problem I have with fecal transplants is they don't really do anything for the small intestine, because you're putting fecal matter from a healthy person into, you know, a person who's unwell. It's going to change a colonic environment, but it's pretty hard to get bugs past the ileocecal valve, or the one-way valve linking the small intestine with the large intestine. So this is why it's very important for the patient to make the right kind of dietary choices, because you're putting all the good nourishment in from the top, which is going to influence everything down below. So if you eat properly, have fermented and cultured foods, have the pre and prebiotic foods that we've spoken about in videos, if you chew your foods properly, if you take a good probiotic for a period of time, particularly some enzymes with it, if you every now and then take some antifungal, antibacterial supplement and some foods, you'll keep that gut environment clean. And that in turn will mean that you won't really get a chronic yeast infection, you know, to a very high degree, very high probability you won't. But I don't really see any clear link between fecal transplant and chronic candida. I see a clear link between incredible wellness. In fact, one of my patients from London, a woman in her 20s, had an incredible outcome with fecal transplant, but it only lasted about 3 months, unfortunately. And when we used probiotics on her long term, we got a fantastic outcome. Don't forget to check out my probiotic enzyme called Canxida Restore. You can see that at canxida.com. Nice product to accompany a protocol like a fecal transplant. So thanks for tuning in, and Tetrid, I hope that answers your question.